So what makes a great entrepreneur? My next guest has spotted some common characteristics that are shared by the world's most successful business people and has used them to identify this year's cream of the crop. Joining us to tell us more is Ernst & Young's Entrepreneurs of the Year 2010 is the company's chairman and chief executive, James Turley. Jim Turley, good to have you with us on Bloomberg.
Great to be here.
Now, how do you actually put together the pieces to figure out what makes a great entrepreneur?
It's a great question. Ernst & Young realized some 25 years ago that the entrepreneurs who were doing so much for societies and job growth and the economies weren't getting enough media attention, candidly. And so we started celebrating them. We started a program that is now in 50 countries around the world where independent judges sift through 5,000 great entrepreneurs every year and pick winners. And so we've actually, through that 25 years, seen a lot of characteristics that are very common across these great people.
Well, explain some of the characteristics. What defines a great entrepreneur? Because also there's a definition you've got to tackle, which is an intrapreneur, because a lot of the entrepreneurial instincts come from people that are already inside companies.
Right. If you think first about broad entrepreneurship, many people don't realize that these men and women don't think about themselves first. They look at the world outside, they see the needs that exist, and then they've got this vision to create an idea, a product, a service to meet the needs. They've got an amazing amount of courage to risk everything, to go follow their dream. And almost every one of the men and women who've been celebrated have a great persistence, because for most of these people, they don't succeed the first time out. They have to pick themselves up, dust themselves off, and do it all over again.
Well, let's use some as an example, because I know that, for example, Howard Lutnick of Cantor Fitzgerald,
right,
entrepreneur, top rank. How did he get there?
Well, you think about what the judges in our program this year focused on very heavily was that might be the ultimate story of picking oneself up and dusting themselves off. Of course, Cantor Fitzgerald, absolute tragedy, September 11, 2001. And Howard and his team did amazing things, both in supporting the men and women that worked for Cantor Fitzgerald, but very much rebuilding the business, and it's gone on to absolutely spectacular things.
Now, what about Larry Silverstein? That also related to 9/11 and now the rebuilding of the World Trade Center site.
Very similar story. It's just a coincidence that both were nominated this year and both ended up getting national recognition through the program.
Now, what kinds of characteristics did he display, this idea of just tenaciousness?
Absolutely. I think that when the judges looked at his story, they saw all the challenges that surrounded the rebuilding of Ground Zero, and they saw how he just went at it, didn't take no for an answer, and is making a great success out of it.
Now, another entrepreneur that you've highlighted, Jack Link, is having to do with Jack Link's beef jerky sausage.
Right. And so what shows through the diversity of the men and women that have been recognized is that it's not all high tech. It's not all what you think of as, you know, the next iPhone or the next iPad. You could have entrepreneurial instincts in almost any business, and it's important that it's not just startups. You also have to have, within large companies, a spirit of entrepreneurship to keep things alive and growing.
Now, how do you do that in a large company? Do you need to institutionalize some process for entrepreneurship?
You very much do. When you look at some really big companies, 3M comes to mind as one that has really institutionalized entrepreneurship. How you encourage people in big organizations to keep that spirit. You've got to have leadership from the top that says this is important, and you've got to make it institutional. That you've got to make sure that the leadership of the business gives some protection to the men and women who are going to be innovating, because just like startups, innovation doesn't work all the time.
When you say protection, does that also include that they need specific time set aside to create these kinds of entrepreneurial ideas that are away from their, quote, day jobs?
No doubt. No doubt you have to create time. You have to put, in a sense, a formal enough structure to give them time to make not just them individually, but the entire organization realize that this is important to the success of the business.
Well, I want to thank you very much, Jim Turley, for sharing your thoughts about entrepreneurship, intrapreneurship, and educating us a little bit about those trends. Thank you very
much
for coming to us from Ernst & Young.